Now, when I wake up and I decide to go on YouTube, the first thing that come across my timeline is Crip Mac getting DP'd by his gang. And who the first I see speaking on it is this little young punk-ass nigga Tazo TV. Tazo fucking TV, the motherfucker with ass in his motherfucking name. I'm so sick of this young-ass punk. Y'all done motherfucking trolled this young man. Y'all done trolled Crip Mac until somebody done really harmed this man. I can't believe you suckers. Then when I look deeper, it's motherfuckers talking about it every motherfucking where. But when I go down this fuck-ass nigga Tazo TV channel, I see 50 videos about Crip Mac. So you're a main instigator in this happening. You're nothing, man. I swear, you're nothing, man. You're a fucking joke, man. Like, seriously, what the fuck is wrong with you, you little young-ass punk? This ain't the way YouTube's supposed to be ran. I don't even like making videos about this young punk. But somebody sent me his video, and I just couldn't believe what I be hearing from this young man. See, I understand the gang culture. I used to gang bang back in the day. That was long, long, long ago. And I'm from California, so I know what goes on down there in them streets. See, down here in Oakland, we don't gang bang blood and crip. We used to chase some guys away from our city. We did neighborhood gangs. So I understand, and it's the same politics everywhere. So I just want to tell Crip Mac that you got to really be careful of your homeboys now, Crip Mac, that you about to get this money. Everybody going to be hating on you now. Everybody trying to come up off your name. And I understand that you love your hood, but focus on your business. You already see what they trying to do to you, Crip Mac. You already see. Cause you go, as long as you keep doing what you're doing, Crip Mac, you always gonna have these fuck ass niggas like Tazo TV, I Smoke Hip Hop, AK-47, The Queen. You gonna have a lot of these guys, a lot of these dudes trying to take you down. You give them something to talk about, Crip Mac. And I understand that's you and your personality, but you still get these motherfuckers something to talk about, and they gonna talk about you, Crip Mac. I like you, you know what I'm saying? You're kinda hilarious. And I see you giving back to the people. I see you giving food to the homeless. And these guys don't like that. They don't like it, Crip Mac. I'm telling you, Crip Mac, they don't like it. You can represent your 5-5, but just know that all them guys don't want to see you alive on 5-5, Crip Mac. So, Crip Mac, I hope this message gets to you, because I don't want to see nothing happen to you. You know, these guys on YouTube is dangerous. Their tongues are dangerous. Crip Mac, they want to see somebody harm you. So watch out for your homeboys, Crip Mac, or you will be a victim of another gang member that's dead in L.A. Like I said, like I gang banged before, but we ain't never did the blood and crip thing. We did neighborhood thing out here in the Bay Area. You know? You understand? So you really gotta be careful, Crip Mac. Because if you don't, they will kill you. They will kill you. And I can take this from Hassan Campbell. His dry snitching ass, but I can still take this from Hassan Campbell. Watch out for your circle before they hurt you. And you about to see all these guys now making videos about you, Crip Mac. They gonna wanna ride your wave. And these dudes is happy. They happy that this even happened to you, Mac. So just be focused and be mindful. And just know, every homeboy ain't your homeboy, Mac. And I'm gone.
In between the lines, real hoods from Cali know the business, whether you a Crip, Blood, or Serrano. But I must say, C-Mac took that poop popping like a G. And if you guys want to know how many fools from his hood DP'd him, it was 9. I saw the video on Instagram before it got taken down. One of his homies from his hood was recorded. But I guess that shit got flagged or something. He didn't get dropped not once. He got a little blemish under the eye, but it's something light. Ain't nothing massive for him. You know, you gon' pull through like a G, you know? Yo, rock with the content. I'ma ask y'all like, comment, subscribe for more videos like this one. I'm out.
February 8th. Top of the morning, Kev. On hood. Now, the situation with yesterday, Kev, with the video, me on the floor, whatever, Kev, me with Crip. Let's keep it 50-50 straight. The nickels I squabble with, you find me with this DP shit, Kev, it's generals, nigga. It's homies that been in the penitentiary. It's homies that's big like me, Kev. Maybe a little smaller, Kev, but they're strong on neighborhood Crip. So it go like this, Kev, on neighborhood Crip. When you get with a program, Kev, and you start winning out here, Kev, it ain't no winning in the situation. Let's go ahead and keep it 50-50 straight. So no, I'm not mad the shit got posted, Kev. And let other motherfuckers around the world know, Kev. Hey, nobody bigger than the program, Kev. Anybody can get put on their hand, enough of them's on neighborhood crib. Now, I'll let people know, cuz I'm nasty on 50s. Years ago, cuz, I was a fucking weirdo. Let's go ahead and keep it 55th Street. Since I got put on 55th Street, and now, and later in life, cuz, ain't been no custer or no smut shit or nothing like that, cuz. Real crippin', real solid. On hood. Well respected and well loved from my hood. You fight me? That situation wasn't supposed for I go like that. But I'm gonna go ahead and keep it 55th Street. I didn't like the attention on me, Kel. I'm a jail nigga. I said, Kel, fuck it. Let's just get this shit off the sway. I'm gonna go ahead and keep it 55th Street. I love all my nickels. And I respect all my nickels. I am a nickel. 55th Street. 55th Street. 55th Street. 55th Street. Five, you slow motherfuckers, this is the fifth. 55th.